Hey, it's Iris. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to answer another question that I got from one of my clients the other day. And that question is, how far ahead should I plan my career and life? Great, great question. Before I go ahead and answer that question, please like this video if you like it and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That will tell me exactly what kind of content you're finding valuable and it will help me to grow my channel. All right, let's get to that question. Maybe the following story resonates with you. You're in your late 20s, 30s, maybe even 40s. And when you look at your career, you can't help but feel a little bit meh. Yeah, sure, you've achieved some great things and you certainly made a lot of progress since you came fresh out of uni, but it just not turned out the way you'd hoped. Maybe you had imagined finding and actually doing your dream job by now. Maybe you simply wish you were further along or had achieved more. Or maybe you thought that you'd be earning more money or be more satisfied with what you're doing right now. I see a lot of people who feel this way after having worked for a while. And they all have something in common. They did roughly the same thing. They took the first job they got offered after uni, then focused on doing really well and responded to opportunities that came their way. Sounds like a pretty decent thing to do, right? Well, unfortunately, that's not the case. What they failed to do is plan their career. They took the backseat and let their career take the reins. They followed a path simply because it was there, without really asking themselves if it's the path that they want to be on, if it's the right path for them. So after about 10, 15, maybe even 20 years, they wonder where on earth they've ended up. And that's why it's so important to plan your career. But planning your career is tricky. We all know that the further into the future we go, the harder it is to plan something. It's much harder to plan what your career is going to be like in, let's say, 10 years from now, than it is to plan what it's going to be like in 1 year from now. And it's much harder to plan what steps you're going to take 9 years from now, than it is to plan what steps you're going to take 9 months from now. So here are two tips to help you along the way. Tip number one, stick to a direction. So as a rule of thumb, I would say make plans for the year ahead, but anything further into the future, stick with a direction that you like to move into. So set aside some time and get a really good idea of what you'd like your career to be like in, let's say, 5 to 10 years from now. Timing doesn't need to be super strict. This isn't about setting goals like on the 1st of September 2028, I'll have achieved X, Y, Z. No, this is more about visualizing the kind of things that you'd like to do and where you'd like to be. For example, would you want to work for yourself? Would you want to work for the likes of Google, Facebook, Virgin, Disney? Or would you prefer to work for a small, exciting, upcoming startup? Would you want to have published a book? Maybe you want to be a well-recognized expert in your sector or field of work and travel the world to speak at conferences and seminars. Or maybe you'd actually prefer to work remotely part-time and spend time with your family and live in the countryside, move away from the big city. And you don't need to meticulously plan all these things out to a T, but instead, with every step that you take and every decision that you're about to make, ask yourself, is this going to help me get a tiny bit closer to those things I'd like to achieve or where I'd like to be? If the answer is yes, then obviously go and do it. And if the answer is no, you might want to think twice about doing this. And research has shown that this is so much more powerful and effective actually than planning everything out to a T. Tip number two, remain open-minded. It's very easy to become too rigid when we start to plan our career and become tunnel visioned on the things that we set out to achieve. When we try to plan every step of the way, we easily limit ourselves because we fail to see unforeseen opportunities when they do arrive. Look, career planning is all about finding that delicate, super delicate balance of knowing the direction that you're heading in, whilst at the same time being open-minded and flexible to things when they come our way. Sometimes the best opportunities really are the ones that we never saw coming and certainly never planned for. Yes, sure, life can throw you a curveball, but on the flip side, life can also throw you the most unexpected and pleasant surprises and opportunities. We just need to be able to spot them when they happen. We need to stay open-minded. That means saying yes to things that scare you. It means questioning the logical next step. It means helping people out without expecting anything in return or directly benefiting from it. It means having conversation with strangers or simply doing something just because you enjoy it without an agenda. It means always trying out new things and learning new things. Try not to control everything and be open to new experiences. Because in the words of Tina Seelig, Stanford professor and best-selling author on creativity, innovation, and entrepreneurship, interesting things occur when you are open to taking an unexpected turn, to trying something different, and when you are willing to question the rules others have made for you. So, when planning your career, remember this. Planning every step of the way is hard, if not impossible. So, don't do it. Instead, stick with that direction and remain open-minded to unforeseen opportunities and experiences. And don't forget to have fun at it. All right. That's all I have for you today. If you like this video, please, please, please hit that thumbs up button. Next week, I'll be talking about making a career change in your 30s and 40s. Are you too old to realistically make a change when you're in your 30s or 40s? You'll find out next week. So if you want to know the answer to that, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next Wednesday.